Hello friends, Dr. Akerkar from Mumbai, India, here at ACR 2017. I was particularly looking at the data about new molecules in psoriatic arthritis, and ACR was really not disappointing in that respect. We have a lot of data about new molecules in psoriatic arthritis here presented. The first molecule on the horizon, tofacitinib, the Opal Broaden and Opal Beyond data presented, showing good efficacy in terms of significant difference in the patient-related outcomes. The Opal Balance study, 36 months data about the safety of tofacitinib, no new safety signals there. And Dr. Van der Heet presented the Opal Broaden study, a study with active psoriatic arthritis patients, those who are refractory to DMARDs, TNF-alpha-9, 422 patients, and the study duration of 12 months. More than 90% of the patients did not have any significant radiological progression. I'm sure 1 year is not that big a duration for radiological progression, but it's the step in that right direction. Coming to the second molecule on the horizon in psoriatic arthritis, ixekizumab. Another study, a phase 3 SPIRIT 2 study data presented with good efficacy with significant difference in the patient-related outcomes. Some data about abatacept in psoriatic arthritis, promising data, but long way to go for abatacept. As far as the established molecules are concerned, apremilast, 4 year safety and efficacy data with apremilast as monotherapy in psoriatic arthritis. Good efficacy with ACR 20, 50, 70 of 68%, 43%, 23% respectively, and a PASI 75 and 50 score of 40 and 67% respectively. So good things as far as apremilast is concerned. And lastly, not to forget, secukinumab, safety data of 7769 patient years of exposure presented here at the ACR. So all in all, as things stand today, good data for psoriatic arthritis and molecules. A lot of things to expect in the future for psoriatic arthritis patients. Thank you.